Hey, everyone. We are live at Pace Studio right now with Mike Ferris. Mike, thank you for being here, man. It's a total pleasure on our side, and we cannot wait to share your music with our viewers.
Thank you, Brian. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, man. So we're going to hear two songs off Silver and Stone, which is out right now on Compass Records, and we're also going to hear one from Shine for All the People, which won the Grammy for Best Traditional Gospel Album in 2015, and we're stoked to hear all of it, man. Can you tell us what you're going to start out with?
You know, I'm going to start, we're going to ease into it a little bit with a song called Running Back to You off of Silver and Stone. Folks say that you found someone new to do the things I used to do for you. So just call out my name. Oh, I'm not ashamed. Oh, I'll come running back to you. I can't sleep at night. Oh, I can't get by. When you were mine, I didn't treat you right. So just call out my name. Oh, I'm not ashamed. Oh, I'll come running back to you. Just like a king, I lost everything. Now I sit alone on my throne. But I got my pride deep down inside. I'm yours and yours alone. Just like a king, I lost everything. Now I sit alone on my throne. But I got my pride deep down inside. I'm yours and yours alone. I try to forget. I have my regrets. This love of ours can always start anew. So just call out my name. Oh, I'm not ashamed. Oh, I come running back. I'll come running back. Oh, 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 I come running back. There could be mistakes today. There could be flubs. Well, but we're live.
Yeah, and it would be boring if you played it exactly the same every single time.
That's so exactly right.
We are privileged to have you here sharing this music with us today. We appreciate it very much. Matt, can you tell us a little bit about, I mean, it sounds like remembering to allow the world, the universe, the natural intelligence that's around us, sometimes take control of the course of what happens next. I'm not phrasing this elegantly. What I'm trying to say is each one of us, you know, at times try to control what's happening in our own lives too tightly. And
yes.
it backfires on everybody. Can you talk a little bit?
Are you pointing a finger at me right now?
Well, I'm pointing four back at myself. Isn't that what they say? Yeah, no, this is coming from a place of empathy. And can you talk a little bit about it? It seems like you have worked on allowing, like not taking too much control over situations and letting things go a little bit, which is seemingly what that song and this album is overwhelmingly about.
There's probably a big parallel going on right there with making Silver and Stone, because as you so aptly and elegantly pointed out that or suggested maybe that I do have I have control issues, and so this whole thing has been a process of letting go, really, you know, and it began right at the beginning, you know, from starting to write the album, you know, and just kind of letting go of everything and going, whatever happens, and that's going to be okay. You know, I don't have to, you know, it's not necessary that I need to put the pressure on me every day to write the next White album. You know what I mean? Just have fun and try to enjoy the process. And then it carried over to the actual recording sessions too, where I was asked by president of my label, Gary West, to produce a record. And so letting him take the helm was a big step for me, to allow him to come in and be a part of that on that level. So, and it's really good, you know, to do that, to have those exercises, especially for, you know, when you have those issues, to kind of let go and just be able to trust other people, you know, allow yourself to trust other people and know that they have your best interest at heart. So, yeah.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad that it turned out this way. I enjoy it quite a bit, and I'm enjoying the performance of it here in this room as well. So
thank you, Brian.
Yeah, man. Can you tell us what you're going to do? Are you going to do another one off Silver and Stone, or are we going to go back to the previous album?
Let's go back to Shine for All the People, shall we? This is a song that was originally a song performed by a guy named Curly Weaver, who was Blind Willie McTell's traveling partner. They were compadres back in Georgia, and for a long time I thought Curly Weaver and Blind Willie McTell, there was stories that they were one and the same, and there was like alias names that Blind Willie would. But anyway, this is a song that I reworked from one of those old recordings from probably 100 years ago. It goes like this. You know what? I'm going to give myself permission. And I'm going to change keys.
Yeah,
there it is. That's the one.
Dude, nobody's going to complain about a little bit more Mike Ferris performance,
there you go.
Man.
This just sounds better too, right? That's perfect. Myself, yeah.
nobody. Do that for me. I got to grow. Cross it for myself. I've got to me. Oh, my dear mother. To me, meter for myself. Can't nobody, yeah, do that for me. Got to cross it for myself. I'm going home over Jordan.
Thank you, Mike.
Thank you, Brian.
Yeah, man. Dude, that sounds great. Can we talk about the Silver and Stone, about the 2019 record, about the current record? And so, dude, as amazing as it sounds solo acoustic here in this room, can we talk a little bit about the arrangement on the album and what people hear and some of the cast of characters that you got to work with in making Silver and Stone?
Yeah, absolutely. We we recorded at the Compass Studios in Nashville, which is the home of Outlaw Country, which is where Willie Nelson and Waylon and Jesse Coulter and Tom Paul Glazier recorded the Outlaws album, the legendary. It was the first platinum-selling country record. It had Mamas Don't Let Your Babies Grow Up Be Cowboys and all that stuff on it. And so we recorded the record in there. And the album turned out to be the best sounding record I've ever made, really. And you know, being in Nashville and being there for as long as I've been, I've been blessed to be surrounded by a lot of great musicians. And, you know, Steve Mackey came in and played bass. He's one of the greatest bass players in the world. Derek Phillips, who's, again, one of the, you know, he's also one of the greatest drummers around. And then you had guys like Reese Winans, who's an old friend of mine, who I played with Double Trouble, which is Stevie Ray Vaughan's old band. And he came in and played Paul Brown on keys. It's really an embarrassment of riches. And I'm drawing a blank here because that's what happens when you been in this business this long and you're, I just turned 50, so Ginkgo Biloba doesn't even work anymore. Gene Chrisman. Gene Chrisman was...
Well, dude, I was about to Google it, but you brained it, so good for you, man.
Yeah. Gene was on that, you know, you make a list of like, you know, like gods that you'd like to have on the record. And the beautiful thing about Nashville is you can just pick up the phone and just call and go, we'll just call him. We'll just call Gene Chrisman, you know, the guy who played on You Make Me Feel Like a Natural Woman. He played on, what was it? Son of a Preacher Man. I haven't had much sleep today. just crazy, crazy stuff, man. He it's amazing what all he's played on. And he came in and played. He played on... Are You Lonely For Me, Baby? And so, yeah, I'm probably missing. Doug Lancio came in and played guitar and was really the all-star of the whole thing. MVP came in and really colored the album and made it what it is, really.
Nice.
And yeah, really blessed to have those guys in my life, man. It's really awesome.
Yeah, man. Well, I'm glad that it happened. And I hope that everyone who's checking out this live stream right now has a chance to check out the record Silver and Stone, because again, as outstanding as it sounds with you and your guitar, with your voice and your guitar at front and center, it's, I mean, obviously you put in a lot of blood, sweat and tears into the album as well. So it's, something to be checked out. Silver and Stone is out right now on Compass Records, and we're about to hear a third song from it right now, right?
Yes. I'm going to do a song. The whole record is really an homage to this amazing angelic human being over here in the corner. Her name's Julie. She's right over here.
Hey, Julie, just off screen. Do you want to do an on-screen thing?
She's over there. Trust me, she's here. And, Julie,
wearing the Stax record t-shirt.
She's wearing her Stax. Awesome. She's cool, man. Yeah. She's cool. We met here in the city 25 years ago. We met here in the city and 25 years ago this year, right? And she walked into a restaurant back in those days, a place called T-Rex. And I was doing a week's worth of interviews with Cream Magazine and Hit Parader. It was back when magazines was still a thing. And she came walking in, and she was the coolest thing I'd ever seen in my life, man. She had this leather jacket on. She had the curly hair. She was real rock and roll. And I was like, holy crap, we got to get this dinner over really fast. And then she suggested we go see Les Paul play. And I was like, oh, my God, I'm in real trouble. Not only does she know who Les Paul is, but she knows that he's not dead. He's alive. And he's playing. She knows where he's playing on a Tuesday night. I was really impressed. So anyway, this album is really an homage to Julie and our marriage and our bond together, and so it was a good place to start for this new little journey we got. And this song is called Tennessee Girl. You ready, Bob? Are you ready, Bob? Huh? That's Bob over there, though. Your name's Brad?
Yeah, dude, I didn't want to say anything about it, but yeah, that's fine.
You're just going to let me walk around and call you Brian all day? I'm officially senile and old. Sit right down, let me tell you the facts. My baby's got two wings, she flies like that. She's alright. Yeah, my baby, she's alright. Anything I want in this great big world, I got right here in my little Tennessee girl. She don't got shoes, but she's good to go. She got Mississippi mud sticking between all her toes. She's all right. Yeah, my baby, she's all right. Anything I want in this great big world, I got right here in my little Tennessee girl. If she got $2, no, I got one. We gonna boogie woogie, you know where. We'll have some fun. She's always right, never wrong. She never leaves no chicken out on the bone. Nah, my baby, she rocks. My baby rolls. She got Music City blues beating on down, deep down in her soul, yeah. Yeah, my baby, she's all right. Anything I want in this great big world, I got right here in my little Tennessee girl. $2, no, I got one. We gonna boogie woogie, you know, we'll have some fun. She's always right, never wrong. She never leaves no chicken on the bone. Now people sit right down, let me tell you the facts. My baby's got two wings, she flies like that. She's all right. Yeah, my baby, she's all right. Anything I want in this great big world, I got right here in my little Tennessee girl. Anything I want in this great big world, I got right here. Little Tennessee girl. Anything I want in this great big world, I got right here in my little Tennessee girl. Did you get that, Bob?
Man, Mike, thank you so much. Julie, thank you so much. This has been great. Have a nice, I mean, it's just a brief walk from here to the Cutting Room. And
yeah.
Have a great show at the Cutting Room tonight. And there's UK dates coming up in mid-June. All the info is up at mikeferrismusic.com. So please travel safely, of course, and best of luck on Silver and Stone. It's out right now on Compass Records. And, man, thank you for the music. This is a total pleasure.
Thank you guys so much, Brad. And thank you for letting us. I wish I could spend hours here looking at these archives. All this stuff is so nerdy, man.
If you ever have an hour to kill in Midtown Manhattan, please do come back, whether we're doing a thing here or not. Please come back.
Man, I would love to, man. There's just way too much nerd material in here. So thank you, guys. Thank you, Bob. See you guys.